O Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be pleasing and acceptable to you, our Rock and our Redeemer. Amen. Advent, the waiting time. Yes, the waiting time for Christmas is upon us again, and I think one of the most striking Bible passages about someone waiting for Jesus to come is found right here in today's Gospel reading, right here in Luke chapter 7. And here we see John the Baptist in prison. He's confused. He's disappointed because the Jesus that has come is not the same Jesus that he was expecting. But what I like about this story is that it forces us to ask ourselves a very important question. What is it that we are waiting for as we await Jesus' advent into our lives? John the Baptist was the last of the great prophets of the Bible. He went through all the land of Judea proclaiming to all people, low and high, rich and poor, religious and secular, that Jesus is coming. Jesus is going to turn the whole world upside down, he says, and nothing is going to be the same. We're going to have to live differently, he says. We're going to have to think differently. We're going to see life differently. And John saw the evil of the system in which he lived, and he called both religious leaders and secular leaders to repent and change their ways because they had both walked away from God. They had both substituted God's law with Roman law. So in other words, John the Baptist was a strong and thunderous voice that cried out in the wilderness, calling everybody to come back to God. He proclaimed that Jesus, the Messiah, is coming soon. He's going to set his people free, so we need to prepare the way of the Lord in our hearts and make his way straight in our lives. And for all that amazing prophetic ministry, we see that John paid the price. It didn't come cheap. Because in today's Gospel reading, we see that he's now in prison for confronting King Herod. And there in prison, weary from trying, disheartened by failure, surely depressed, and even now struggling with his faith, John the Baptist sends two messengers to ask Jesus a question. Are you the one? Are you the one who is to come, or should we expect someone else? You can practically hear the desperation here in his voice, can't you? Are you the one who I spent my entire life preparing for? Are you the one I gave up everything for to announce? Are you the one who will set your people free, or have I just been wasting my time? But what does Jesus answer? He says, tell John that the dead are raised, the blind see, the lame walk, and the poor have the good news preached to them. Notice not a single word here is mentioned about revolution. Not a single word here is mentioned about thunderbolts coming down from the sky and striking down the corrupt religious system of the time. No talk about overthrowing King Herod and the Emperor of Rome with an army led by Messiah. What John the Baptist was waiting for, what John had been expecting when Jesus finally came, the rise of the physical kingdom of God on earth, is not what came. Because Jesus had come to do something completely different, something completely unexpected, something new and different that John the Baptist was not expecting. For the kingdom of God is not of this world, Jesus says. Jesus came to preach the good news to us who are poor in spirit, so that we who are spiritually deaf can hear God calling us. Jesus came to us so we who are spiritually blind can now see God loving us. Jesus came so that we who are leprous with the disease of sin can now be forgiven and made clean. Jesus came so that we who are spiritually lame can now find strength to get up and walk and live the life that God created you and me to live. Jesus came so that we who are now spiritually dead can now rise and experience abundant life here in this world and eternal life in the next. And as we draw closer to Christmas, John the Baptist's question now becomes our question to answer. What is it that we're waiting for? What is it that we're waiting for as we await Jesus' advent into our lives? Are we looking for quick fixes for the pains and the wounds in our soul? Are we looking for true and lasting healing that only comes from a life walking with Jesus? Are we looking for those warm, fuzzy feelings that come from religious sentimentality? Or are we looking for the new, abundant life of the Spirit which alone can center us and give our lives direction? During this time of advent, may you experience Jesus coming to you in new, surprising, and completely unexpected ways. Amen.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, we thank you that you promised to come is true. You do come. You have come. And we pray that the Jesus that we conjure up in our heads would not confuse us for the Jesus that you really are, a God who gives peace, a God who gives life, abundant life. We pray that you would help us to cling to you, to stay close by your side, and give us the life that our heart and our souls long for. Show us abundant life, we pray, this Advent. We pray these things in Jesus' powerful name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.